In this problem, we're computing the impact velocity of a projectile. In other words, what's the velocity right when it hits the ground? So there's our final velocity vector right when the projectile hits the ground, and we're going to call that V. And our goal is to put this in polar form, meaning we need to get the magnitude of that velocity vector, or the speed, and we need to get a direction labeled as an angle. So we have a pretty standard setup for a projectile launch here. This projectile is launched 2.1 meters off the ground. It has an initial speed of 6.5 meters per second, and the launch angle is 30 degrees. And we start thinking about what we need to determine this final velocity vector when it hits the ground. Well, the idea is that we need the final velocity components, and then we'll do the trigonometry to put those together into polar form. So to start things out, I'm going to break the initial velocity into its velocity components. So there's the horizontal and vertical initial velocity components. The horizontal one, we'll call that V0x. And the vertical one, we'll call that V0y. And we compute these in the usual way. V0x is going to be 6.5 cosine of 30, and that gives us about 5.63 meters per second. And V0y, that's 6.5 sine 30, and that gives us 3.25 meters per second. And remember, in projectile motion, the x velocity never changes, so we actually have one of our final velocity components immediately. I know that Vx, in other words, the final x velocity, is equal to the initial, so that's going to be about 5.63 meters per second, and that part of the problem is done. So then we start thinking about how to get the final y velocity. And we notice in this problem that we don't care how much time has gone by during the projectile flight. This makes the time-independent kinematics equation an attractive option here. I can write down that Vy squared, the final y speed squared, is equal to V0y squared plus 2 times the y acceleration times y minus y naught. That's the final y position minus the initial. Now, of course, the y acceleration is just negative g here because vertically this is a free fall problem. So we have everything in this equation except the final y speed, and we can go ahead and plug everything in and solve for Vy. I want to point out that y final is 0. If we're using a standard coordinate system where we put the origin at the floor, and then everything else can just be plugged in. So I have 3.25 squared minus 2 times g. We're going to use 9.8 for that. And then I have a negative y naught, and y naught is 2.1 meters. So if we smash all those numbers together, we get on the right hand side of the equation about 51.72. We still have to square root to solve for Vy. And that gives us about 7.19 meters per second. So now that we have these two velocity components, we can just draw a triangle showing those velocity components, adding head to tail, and then we'll get the hypotenuse of that. That's going to be the speed, and we'll label an angle. So there's our diagram, and we have the final rightward x velocity component of about 5.63 meters per second, and then our final downward y velocity component with a magnitude of 7.19 meters per second. And now we just have to put these together. So to find the hypotenuse here, in other words, the final speed, we just use the Pythagorean theorem, and I get the square root of 5.63 squared plus 7.19 squared. And this gives us a final speed of about 9.13 meters per second. So we could call that the impact speed of the projectile. Now finally, we want to get the angle of impact to complete the polar form of this vector. And that's going to be the angle whose tangent, in other words, the inverse tangent of 7.19 over 5.63. Now if you want this to come out with a minus sign on it, that's fine. You could put the minus sign on the y component there and theta will come out with a minus sign. But I normally ask my students to just draw a picture so it's clear what theta is, and then just use positive numbers for all the components, and it makes it clear how big the labeled angle is. So when I run the numbers on this, I get an impact angle of 51.9 degrees. So there it is, the impact velocity in polar form, meaning we have a magnitude, that's 9.13 meters per second, and we have a direction that we'll call 51.9 degrees below the horizontal. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, And best of luck on your math and physics journey.